Gone. Joseph gets him again. 1, 2, 3, he says. An El Dorado celebration. Cornwall departs. Man there again. And taken again. They're roaring. The Kings in front of the home crowd, and Joseph strikes.
First short one. First really short one. Good catch. And that was a long time in coming. He's got him in his pocket.
It's gone straight up. And Clark takes it comfortably. That is real maturity and a big wicket. Khan goes, and look at the stare.
He had already used his one short ball for the over, so he went hard length. And given that McKenny Clark hasn't had a great night in the field along the ground, that's a real confidence booster. Deadly silence and a stare from Alzarri.
Oh! Not only does he close it out, he gets the most valuable wicket. That of Nicholas Pooran.
Joseph again. He is too good. Rallying his troops. The King's on fire.
Well, if you're going to get a first up delivery like that, it is a little unfortunate from a batting perspective. It's a cracker. There's outward movement, it's bounced at your first sighter, and that nervous little flirt with the bat is just so common.
Good pace.
Oh, he got him, I think. I reckon that's out. I reckon that's out. Top.
Excellent fielding. Ah, oh, yes. Having an effect on the game. Alzarri Joseph.
Could be out this. Lobbed it straight and he's strolling away looking rather dejected. That's the wicket.
That is some delivery. Rajapaksa went up straight away. Alzarri wasn't interested.
I'm looking forward to this, just to see if there's a little bit of glove involved. Rajapaksa was very keen. That's all good, thank goodness. Tall, rangy fellow that is Alzarri Joseph. Watch this on a great length, into the surface. Away she goes. The bounce, that's so impressive. This is the ultimate ultra edge. Oh, hello. Yeah. Little tickle, Nickel. How do we know? Did somebody send a
signal? And this is Alzarri Joseph at his absolute best. So hard to face. First delivery of the over was close to 144 kilometers per hour. This one a touch slower, but straighter. And it brushes the glove.
Boys over the line. That's gone to the moon. And not quite. Oh, it's over. Yeah, I think that's six. Is this, who's this? Hatzigaloo out there. Peter Hatzigaloo. They think it's six. They'll just check it. But my goodness, it went a long way up from Mark Dale.
Yeah, these are never easy. Even if you have lots of room on the boundary, which he didn't, they're still not easy. You can see the substitute fielder, Kimani Milius, just signaling six. He was closest to Hatzigaloo and will need confirmation. He did well to take the catch, but you can see from the reactions there that he too feels that he touched the boundary rope. Legal delivery, and that's good from Alzarri. If he takes the catch, no problems there. It's the foot thereafter. Very close. Releases the ball. Does he release in time? And does his foot, his right knee, touch the boundary cushion? will perhaps need a different angle or something else to give us a clearer indication. Is he touching the ground there? Did he release the ball in time? And a difficult one for the umpire. It's out of his hand now. He's not touching the ground outside the boundary at that point. Does he release it in time? It's still in his hand. There's no contact yet. He might just have released it in time. But does his foot touch the boundary? This angle might give us a better indication from the inside of the boundary. Outside looked okay. Look at that right knee. Is there contact? What do you think, Danny Morrison? Eagle-eyed.
I'm telling Mr. Basarath, who is our television up, that he's touched it there. You can see he has. He's actually just moved the boundary cushion. When it comes down with that right knee and thigh, yeah, there. See, he's still holding onto the ball. Still holding onto the ball. And it's been brushed with the thigh. Now, listen, it's already after 11 p.m. Not wanting to see the sun come up at this stage. I think he's touching there. My view, he's touching and he's disturbed the boundary cushion with that thigh, that right thigh. Zed Basara still wanting to have another look about there of that. Bumping it there, touching there, still holding on to the ball. Often is the case, the more you have a look at it, more and more replays that go on and the length of it, the more it actually goes in favour of the batter. But stranger things have happened. I'd love to see a real-time replay. That's what I'd love to see. Great game of cricket, T20. Really do have to get on with a decision. And that Zayed Basarath is our TMO, and it's up to him to make a decision. Let's have it. What's he gone with? Is he going with OUT? He's going with OUT! Mark Dale is going to have to trudge off here. They're saying Peter Hatzegalu has come up with the goods here.
Yeah, that was brilliant, absolutely brilliant. And another reason why you can't always take the fielder's word. Dale goes for a very well-played 57, 132 for three.